Hello everyone, my name is Jigdish. So today, we are going to study about the solar radiation measurement. So there are the two basic types of the instruments to measure the solar radiation. So among that, the first one is the pyrheliometer, second one is pyranometer. So there is a little bit of difference between these two devices. So first, in the sessions we have to study about the pyrheliometer. The pyrheliometer is the one type of an instrument that is used to measure the direct solar radiation. So it means that it measures only the beam radiations or the direct radiation. So which the solar radiations which are not scattered, not absorbed or not reflected by the atmosphere, so such radiations is called as a direct radiation. So the pyrheliometer measures the direct radiation. The pyrheliometer is designed by the Armstrong and it looks like the long tube telescope. So this is the picture of that pyrheliometer. So in the circuit diagram, it contains these two strips S1 and S2. S1 is blackened. Here, the one junction of the thermocouple is connected to S1 and another junction of the thermocouple is connected to S2. So what is the thermocouple means? So your thermocouple is a device so which has the two terminals of different temperatures. So generally the one junction is in a hot condition, so another junction is in a cold condition. So whenever there is a temperature difference between the two terminals, so whenever both are made up of different materials or different conductors, in such cases a potential difference is developed between the two terminals. So that is nothing but the Seebeck effect. This thermocouple works on the principle of Seebeck effect. So here there are the two terminals S1 and S2. So S1 is open to solar radiation, but S2 is shielded. So it is shielded by the some metal surface. So shielded means the solar radiation should not fall on the strip S2. The S2 is connected to a circuit, so which contains the voltmeter, which is used to measure the potential difference between the two terminals, and it is connected to ammeter. So A is ammeter which measures the current, and BA is a battery, K is plug key, RH is rheostat. So rheostat is used to vary the current or the voltage. A sensitive galvanometer is also connected to the thermocouple. Here, so first, when both the strips S1 and S2 are shielded from the solar radiation. In this diagram, so when both the strips S1 and S2 are at the same temperature, whenever we are not supplying any solar radiations on S1 or S2, so S2 is shielded, there is no chance of falling the solar radiations on it. So whenever S1 and S2 are at the same temperature, then the galvanometer shows zero deflection. Now the strip S1 is exposed to solar radiation and S2 is shielded with a cover M. As soon as the strip S1 receives the sun energy or the heat radiation from the sun, its temperature rises. So here the temperature of the strip S1 rises and S2 remains same. The magnitude of the current, produced in the circuit, so will be equal to the amount of radiation which falls on the strip S1. That is the amount of solar radiation falls on the strip S1. So then the galvanometer shows the deflection. So this is the first case. So this is shielded, S2 is shielded and S1 is irradiated with the sunlight, then the galvanometer shows deflection. Now the current is passed through the strip S2, and so the galvanometer shows zero deflection. It means that now we are supplying the current through the battery by adjusting the rheostat. So we have to adjust the rheostat such that the galvanometer deflection should be zero. So whenever we get the galvanometer deflection zero, then the voltmeter reading and ammeter reading should be noted. Here the value of potential difference and the current is measured by using these devices. Once this happens, so we can obtain the voltage and current reading if the quantity of heat radiation incident on unit area in a unit time on the strip S1 is denoted as capital Q, and A is the absorption coefficient of a strip S1, then the total amount of radiation absorbed by the strip S1 in a unit time, so can be written as S1 is equal to Q into A into A. A capital A is the area of the strip S1, so or area of the strip S2, both are the same, both are having the same area, but we are considering only the area of the strip S1 here. The heat produced in a time, in a unit time by the strip S2. So after supplying the current to the strip S2, the heat is produced. That heat produced can be measured as, that is the product of potential difference and the current, where V is the potential difference and I is the flow of current through it. When the total amount of radiation absorbed by the strip S1 and is equal to the amount of radiation produced by the strip S2, so both these temperatures are equal. So at that condition, so we have to write the both the equations, that is QAA is equal to VI. So from this we can calculate the Q value, that is Q is equal to VI by A into A. By substituting the value of the potential difference, current and area and absorption coefficient value, so we can calculate the amount of radiation received from the strip S1. By using the same formula, we can calculate the solar constant, that is S is equal to VI by A into A. So here the what is the solar constant means? So solar constant is nothing but the amount of solar radiation received on the earth surface per unit area and unit time. So it is known as a solar constant. That value is found to be, that is 1347 watt per meter square. So that can also be calculated by using this formula. And there are the main advantages of this perihelionometer is, so it consumes very less power, and it operates in a wide range of voltage supplies, and its stability is more. And there are so many applications of the perihelionometer, so that is used in the scientific meteorological purposes, and it is used to observe the changes in the climate and to calculate the solar constant and testing the research of the materials and estimation of the solar collector efficiency. In this session, so we studied about the pyrheliometer. In the next sessions, we should study about the pyranometer. So there is a small difference between the pyrheliometer and the pyranometer. In the next session, so we should study about the pyranometer. Thank you all.